Hello, my dear children. Welcome. Welcome all to our English time. How are you all? Are you all right? This is the fourth part of the English time. Are you ready? Today, I have a number of activities. Ready? Ready for the class? Very good. Do you have textbook and notebook with you? Shall we start? കഴിഞ്ഞ ക്ലാസ്സിൽ നമ്മൾ എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് ചർച്ച ചെയ്തത്? നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഓർമ്മയുണ്ടോ? Yeah, we read the fisherman's story. Did you read the whole story? We discussed the whole story, right? കഥ വായിച്ചതിന് ശേഷം എന്താണ് ചെയ്തത്? We heard a story. Do you remember? The story of two boys. Do you remember their names? Yes, Kichu and Lalu. They went for fishing. Who fooled them? Yeah, the fish fooled them. That was an interesting story, wasn't that? At the end of the class, I gave an activity to do. What activity? A conversation, right? A conversation between fisherman and his wife. Correct. Ellarum ezhuthiyalle? Ezhuthi ningalde teacher kaichu koduthu? Very good. I also got some conversations. Shall we see some of them? എന്തായിരുന്നു കോൺവെർസേഷൻ എഴുതാൻ പറഞ്ഞ സന്ദർഭം? ആ കണ്ണാടി വീണു പൊട്ടി. ആ ചില്ലുകളിൽ മീൻപിടുത്തക്കാരനും ഭാര്യയും അവരുടെ പ്രതിബിംബം കണ്ടതായിരുന്നു സന്ദർഭം. അത് അവരാണെന്ന് അവർ മനസ്സിലാക്കി കാണുമോ? എന്ത് ധാരണയിലാണ് നിങ്ങൾ സംഭാഷണം എഴുതിയത്? സം ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് തിങ്ക് ദാറ്റ് ദ ഫിഷർമാൻ ആൻഡ് ദ വൈഫ് didn't know that. They still think that the images are their father and mother. Some of our friends think that they understood that. What? Yeah, the images were their own. ഏതാവും ശരി? രണ്ടിനും സാധ്യതയുണ്ടല്ലേ. അതുപോട്ടെ, അവരിപ്പോഴും വഴക്കിടുകയാണോ? അതോ വഴക്കൊക്കെ അവസാനിപ്പിച്ച് രമ്യതയിൽ ശാന്തതയിൽ സംസാരിക്കുകയാണോ? എങ്ങനെയാണ് നിങ്ങൾ ഭാവനയിൽ കണ്ടത്? വ്യത്യസ്ത ഭാവനകളുണ്ടല്ലേ. ഇൻ സം കോൺവെർസേഷൻസ് ദ ആർ സ്റ്റിൽ ക്വാറലിംഗ്. ഇൻ സം അതേഴ്സ് ദ ഫിഷർമാൻ ആൻഡ് ഹിസ് വൈഫ് സ്റ്റോപ്ഡ് ഫൈറ്റിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ദ ആർ ടോക്കിംഗ് കാംലി, റൈറ്റ്? നൗ ലെറ്റ് അസ് റീഡ് ദിസ് കോൺവെർസേഷൻ. Conversation between fisherman and his wife. Fisherman, You broken my picture. Wife. Not I am. You did it. Fisherman. Now I can't see my dear father. Wife. Yes, me too. Can't see my dear mother. Fisherman. We should not have quarreled. Wife. Yes, you are right. Fisherman. Shall we collect the pieces? Wife. Yes, of course. Both put them together. Both. We haven't missed our father and mother. Let us check the punctuations first. Are there capital letters, question marks, full stops, etc.? Look at the words fisherman and wife here. Don't we need capital letters in the beginning? Of course, the F in fisherman must be capital letter and the W in wife must be capital letter. Are there full stops at the end of the sentences? We can add punctuation at the end of each sentence, right? So that's over. Now read this sentence. Wife, not I am, you did it. A word is excess in the sentence. We don't need that word. Which word? Yeah, right. Am is not needed. Not I is enough, okay? Now read the sentence. You broken my picture. Check the underlined word. A slight change is needed there. Can you say that? The word should be broke, not broken. The sentence should be, you broke my picture, right? And finally, let's have a look at the spellings. Here, the spelling of you is not correct. You can correct it, can't you? So now the conversation is okay. You should read your conversations well. Correct the mistakes. You can include new ideas also. സ്ക്രീനിൽ കണ്ട സംഭാഷണത്തിൽ നിന്ന് പുതിയ ഐഡിയാസ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടിയില്ലേ? അതുകൂടി നിങ്ങളുടെ സംഭാഷണങ്ങളിൽ ചേർക്കുമല്ലോ, അല്ലേ? Now let me ask you a question. What is a mirror for? To see our image, right? When do you use a mirror? Can you say? We cannot say that, right? We use mirror many times a day. We use it to make up our face, comb our hair, check our dress, and so and so. Thus, we use a mirror for number of purposes. Mirror makes us beautiful. Is it true? Can a mirror make us beautiful? കണ്ണാടിക്ക് നമ്മളെ സുന്ദരമാക്കാനൊന്നും കഴിയില്ല. പറ്റുമോ? ഇല്ല. അത് നമ്മളെ യഥാർത്ഥമായി കാണിച്ചു തരും. They show us our real face, that's all. What will the mirror do if we laugh in front of it? Our image will also laugh, right? If we cry, yeah, the mirror will show the crying face, right? Very good. Shall we play a game now? A mirror game, okay? You know what a mirror does. It imitates us. If I cry, the mirror will show me crying. Now, I will do many things in front of the mirror. Where is the mirror? You are my mirror. You are all mirrors. So, you should imitate me. Do as I do. Got it? ഞാൻ കൈ ഉയർത്തിയാലോ? നിങ്ങളും കൈ ഉയർത്തണം, അല്ലേ? ഇതാണ് കളി. If I smile, you will also smile. Got the task? Now get ready. All of you stand up and get ready. Ready? Is everyone ready? I will show some gestures. You will also do. What will you do? you will do the same. Okay? How is the game? Liked it? Fine. പിന്നീട് വീട്ടിലുള്ളവരുമായി ഈ കളി കളിക്കുമോ നിങ്ങൾ? Who will you play with? With your brother, sister or your friend? You can play with your friends when you go to your school. Okay? അടുത്തുള്ള കുട്ടികൾക്ക് കൂടി പഠിപ്പിച്ചു കൊടുക്കണം. You can play this game when you go to your school. Okay? Very good. നമ്മൾ കണ്ണാടിയെ കുറിച്ചാണ് പറഞ്ഞത്. കഴിഞ്ഞ കഥയും ഒരു കണ്ണാടിയുടെ കഥയായിരുന്നു. ഇനി മറ്റൊരു കണ്ണാടി കഥയായാലോ? ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എ ന്യൂ മിറർ സ്റ്റോറി, ബട്ട് എ സ്റ്റോറി വിത്ത് എ ഡിഫറൻസ്. ആർ യു റെഡി? ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി ഓഫ് ടു ചിൽഡ്രൻ ലൈക്ക് യു. Their names are Ammu and Arun. Arun is Ammu's brother. It was a Sunday, so they were at home. The afternoon was rainy. The rain was drizzling down. Ammu, I feel bored, Arun said. Me too, Ammu said. Where shall we go? See, it is raining. We can't go out, Ammu said. Shall we go up to the attic? Arun said. Attic? It is full of old things. Mother will scold us if we go there, said Ammu. Mother won't see. She is sleeping now. Come on, Arun said. Ammu and Arun walked up the stairs. The old stairs were made of wood. It made a creaking sound. Slowly, Ammu and Arun reached the attic of the house. It was dark there, full of dust. Arun looked up. Oh, how many spiders! He exclaimed. The roof of the attic was full of spiders' webs. There was a small window on one side. Ammu opened the window. Creak! The old wooden window pane opened with a creaking sound. A big beam of light entered the room. Now they can see the things there. Ding dong! The old clock on the wall struck 5 times. 5 o'clock? I think the clock is wrong. It must be 3 o'clock now, Arun said. There was an old table and some damaged chairs on the corner of the room. Hey, don't touch. They are full of dust, Ammu said. But look at this one, Arun pointed to a large mirror on the floor. There was no dust on it. It was clean, very clean. Look, there is no dust on it. It's quite surprising, Arun said. You are right, said Ammu, looking at the mirror. The mirror reflected the image of the children. You look very nice in the mirror, Arun said. You too, Ammu said. Arun touched Ammu's image on the mirror. His hand went straight through the mirror, as if he had touched water. The surface of the mirror was like water. Who? ഹി വിഡ്രൂ ഹിസ് ഹാൻഡ്. അമ്മൂ അരുണും പേടിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടാവും അല്ലേ? എന്താ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് തോന്നുന്നത്? അവർ ഇനി എന്താവും ചെയ്യുക? എന്താണ് നിങ്ങളുടെ ഊഹം? നമുക്ക് ചില കൂട്ടുകാരുടെ അഭിപ്രായങ്ങൾ കേട്ടാലോ.
അവർ പേടിച്ച് കണ്ണാടിയെ നോക്കി നിന്നതാണ്.
കുട്ടികൾ പേടിച്ച് അമ്മേരടുത്തേക്ക് ഓടി.
They will run towards their mother.
What do you think? Will they run down? Will they call their mother? Let us see. The children looked each other in amazement. Taking some courage, Ammu stretched her hand towards the mirror. What a surprise! Her hand went through it. She pulled her hand back. She checked her hand. No, no problem. Her hand was okay. This is really funny, Arun said. Now the children got some courage. They got free from fear. They stretched both their hands and pulled them back. Shall we step into the mirror? Asked Arun. Yes, Ammu agreed. Ready? 1, 2, 3. The children stepped into the mirror. Soon they disappeared into the mirror. Now, my dear children, what happened to Ammu and Arun? Can you say? Where are they? നിങ്ങളാണ് അരുണും അമ്മുവെങ്കിൽ ഇങ്ങനെ ചെയ്യുമോ? What happened to the children? Let's see. Now listen to me. Ammu and Arun fell on a grassy land. They were crying aloud. They got up suddenly. It was almost dark. They looked around in fear. Where are we? Asked Arun. See, it looks like a forest, Ammu said. Big trees, big plants. The branches of tall trees hid the sunlight. So it was dark there. Is it real? Arun asked. I think we are in a magical world. That mirror is a magic mirror. They saw a small path through the grass and plants. They walked along the path. They reached a field. It was a green field, a green open field. The field was covered with plenty of flowers, the flowers of different sizes and colors. Red, blue, white, yellow. Butterflies were flitting from flowers to flowers. They were also of different colors. The children found some small sparrows also. All were busy. They were drinking honey from the flowers. They didn't notice the children. Hey, look there. Arun pointed to some distance. Oh, I can't believe this. Ammu put both her hands on her head. What did Ammu and Arun see there? Ammu said, I can't believe this. What made Ammu wonderstruck? Do you want to know that? അത് ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു തരില്ല, നിങ്ങൾ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കണം. ഞാനൊരു ക്ലൂ തരാം. യു വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ദ ആൻസർ ഫ്രം ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ്. ദ സ്റ്റോറി ഐ ടോൾഡ് യു ഈസ് ഇൻ യുവർ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്. റീഡ് ഇറ്റ്, ഓക്കെ? ദ സ്റ്റോറി ഈസ് ഇൻ പേജ് 16 and 17 ഓഫ് യുവർ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്ക്. ദ ടൈറ്റിൽ ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി ഈസ് മാജിക് മിറർ. Read the whole story and tell me what happened to Ammu and Arun. Okay? Then write the main events of the story in your notebook. കഥയിലെ പ്രധാന സംഭവങ്ങൾ എഴുതി നിങ്ങളുടെ ടീച്ചർക്ക് അയച്ചു കൊടുക്കുക. We can see in the next English time. Bye bye.